Hi everyone, you're watching Redhead Gaming, and we're back playing Splatoon in the second North American Splatfest. This is my second play session. What I'm going to try and do is I'm going to try and get myself up to the Defender rank. I don't think I'm going to get all the way up to the Champion rank in 45 minutes, but we'll see if we can get as far as we can. So let's get started. There we go. It's always the most suspenseful thing ever when you're sitting there waiting for your team to form and the timer's slowly counting down and then it gets all the way to zero and oops, three people instead of four. And I remember during the last Splatfest there were times when it would be the same team against other people on the same team, so I don't completely remember how those worked out, like whether that team got all the points or whatever, but hopefully we won't run into that this time around. Oh yes, we did. Of course. The one time I start talking about it, we end up with only three people. So we're kind of at a disadvantage now. I can't believe more people would rather slide down a water slide than ride a roller coaster. I mean, come on. Oh dear. I mean, the one advantage to only having three people on my team instead of four is that I'm able to get a little bit more points than usual because I'm doing all this coverage myself. And down. Oh, hello! Ugh. Oh dear. Oh dear. I had to retreat there first. Oh dear. Okay. I'm gonna snipe this person. There we go. Just in time, too. I was about to run out of ink. Oh, hello. Oh dear. Okay. Looks like some of the other people on my team are sort of encroaching on their home turf, which is good, but I really need to try and capture that area down there as much as I can. One thing that when you play with less people than normal, so like when less than three on a team of four, or even less than that, the entire arena just seems so deserted. I mean, these stages were definitely meant for four people against four people, and if there's anything less than that, it can just feel so deserted. There's just, like, nobody over here. Like, it's just me and the Squid Sisters. Hey, Squid Sisters. And I'm being invaded. I'm being invaded. Resistance is futile. I only say it because my sister and I were just recently watching Star Trek Deep Space Nine. I know that has nothing to do with that, but... Well, I guess it does. The first episode is all about the Borg and stuff, so I guess. Oh my gosh, we actually won. Did we win? Did we actually win that? It looked like we were gonna win that. My goodness, we won that! 3-on-4 and we still won. That's awesome. There we go. So one more win and I'll get up to the defender rank, which is where I want to be. Like I said, I really don't feel committed enough to this game to try and go for the champion rank, because I've been doing other stuff all day today, and so this is the only other time that I'm gonna get to play this today. So hopefully this video will be uploaded before midnight, so that it actually still is part of the Splatfest. But we'll see about that. Miss Moo, hello Miss Moo. And Allison and John and question mark. I'm going to kill you. Not really, I'm not going to kill you. Don't actually think that I'm going to kill you. I'm going to make you go splat, but I'm not going to kill you. Because killing is bad. And we're going to go straight down the center this time. Try to get as far into the other side as possible. Sort of make a path. That's interesting. The ink kind of has a really, really, like, during this nighttime Splatfest game, the ink really has just this tiny glow, and I think that looks nice. It's like everything's under a black light, kind of. I mean, that actually fits, considering that, I guess Splatfest doesn't take place at night, as opposed to, it looks like it actually really takes place in, like, twilight, which makes it look really, really nice. Alright, let's go. Let's see who's... Jump right over to Miss. Is that Miss T? Miss T? I have no idea. Nima T. Sounds like a toad name. If you guys have played Paper Mario, any of the Paper Mario games, all of the toads, like Toad Town and Rougeport, they're all like a name and then T. So, like, for the toads that you make recipes with, there's Tasty in Paper Mario, and then Zesty in Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door, and I don't know who the recipe lady is in Super Paper Mario, if there is one, and Paper Mario Sticker Star, well, you've got me. I don't know what the heck's going on with that game. I mean, gameplay is real fun. I love the sticker stuff, but I mean, no story. It's too bad that happened, but I mean, it's still a pretty good game. I keep running out of ink. And I'm not doing very well in this match. And I'm not nowhere near my target score of 700. No, I'm probably making rookie mistakes. If you think I'm a terrible Splatoon player, let me know in the comments below. And I think we might have won that. It's... Can't really see it on the gamepad. Oh, now you can. Now you can. Looks like they launched an ink strike right there at the end. Hey, we won. Alright. Cool. My winning streak goes up. Third place, I can dig it. There we go, now I'm a defender. So now at the very least, I'll get 5 sea snails, so that's good. But because I have the time, I'm gonna keep on playing for a little bit to support my team as a roller coaster defender. So like I've said before, I typically don't comment during videos unless it's necessary, so that's why there are lots of times when it's just the music playing, and obviously because I just leave the music playing without talking, the YouTube's data farm or its brains or whatever recognize that it's playing the track of Splatoon music, and the video gets claimed by Nintendo for copyright. So because I don't have it set up to monetize, that's why you're still seeing it, but it's just Nintendo would have just taken that down. It's alright, because I'll choose to not have this video monetized if it means that people get to see it. Oh, X Strike! That's okay, I can cover for that. Not a big deal. Considering I was already in the neighborhood. Become a running gag. I need to. This was just a completely random thought, but I need to start writing some little blurbs to say. Let me know in the comments below, just again as a fun thing. Like, just to be completely non-serious about it. I keep forgetting that when you engage your special weapon, like in my case, the bomb rush. It completely refills the ink of your main weapon. I keep forgetting about that. Like my younger sister, who's been playing this game a lot just like me, she was the one who originally pointed out to me, and now I just keep forgetting about it. So sorry. Should have gotten that person while they were using their ink strike. Let's hide in here and go. Blah, 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 blah. There we go. A little bit of ambush tactics there. Good, 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 good. And my friend's there to clean up my mess, so that's alright. And I'm doing pretty well. Still, okay, fine. Go ahead, follow me. Jeez, sorry I got in your way. As I was saying, I'm doing pretty well in terms of score. I may hit 800. If I hit 800, it doesn't look like I'm gonna hit 800. Or maybe. Maybe, come on. Oh, come on, 800. There we go. I was less concerned about winning at that point, more of just getting my score up to 800. And there we are. Nicely done, nicely done. Thank you, Judd. Yeah, I'm not gonna be playing this for more than another 15 minutes or so, so I'm not gonna get up to the next rank. But it's okay, because every win that I get is a win for my team, and it helps my winning streak. Maybe by the end of this recording session, I'll get up to the so hot rank, which that would be fun. Just be a fun way to immortalize myself. So one thing that I just noticed is probably you'll see on the videos that the capture has really huge black borders. I thought that the borders were fixed, but they're not. So in this video and the one previous have big black borders, but after this I'll make sure I recalibrate the screen size of my TV, because I can see here in front of my TV, I can see a tiny bit of black border. So that will be fixed in the next video that I do for this. Like, it may be as far out as I can go, but I'm pretty sure there's room for expansion. I'm just going all over the place. I don't know what the heck I'm doing. There we go. So my apologies if this video seems like it's a little bit smaller than what it's supposed to be. I mean, it's coming from my Wii U, so that's just the stupid thing that the Wii U does with the sizing of the television screen and blah, 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 blah. Even if, like, I basically... So just a little behind-the-scenes stuff. In order for me to make it so that the capture that you're seeing right now is completely full frame, I have to basically adjust the screen size on my television so that the image that the Wii U is putting out to the television is actually bigger than the television screen itself. So I get some cutoff on all sides, and I really don't like that. So, I mean, this may be bad for the people at home who are watching, or it might not be, but I would much rather have a little bit of black borders on my screen than make it a little bit more difficult to play the game. Especially if it's a game that I haven't played before. That's always tough because there could be things I'm missing. I remember when I had my PlayStation. I have an original PlayStation, which I'm pretty sure still works. Don't have a lot of games for it. I have Bugs Bunny Lost in Time, and I've got the three Spyro games, but I mean, that's about it. But the PlayStation, when I would play it on certain TVs, I would lose some of the picture, and I would always be like, whoa, why does it look like that? Well, I finally figured it out, so there's that. But that's the problem that my Wii U's got right now, so hopefully I'll be able to get it as close to fixed as possible, but I'm not going to be able to do full frame for you guys watching because it would just make it a little too difficult for me to play. And I would rather it be easier and a lot better for me to make the content the way it's supposed to be rather than worrying about the frame. And I got 666 points again. In the last video, I got 666 points. Yeah, I know, that's really, really weird. And I think that I ended up getting, what else? There was something else that was 66. I don't even remember. But it was 666 points. And then another 66 somewhere, and it's in the previous video, you'll be able to see it. Alright, let's play a few more rounds. Looks like I'm gonna get two or three more rounds in, possibly. So we'll see how that goes. Alright, let's get rolling again. One thing that I will be kind of happy about when this is all over is that we go back to, like, rotation of colors, because I love it. One of the things I love about this game is that the colors change in every match, and it adds to the variety so much. I mean, I really like the crimson color from the first North American Splatfest, but I mean, I like rotating colors so much better. Okay, is that what we're doing? Is that what we're doing? You're just gonna shoot from there? All right, yeah, there you go. Come down and fight me. There we go. You're dead. I'm splatted. Sorry. No killing. There's no killing in this game. It's only splatting. My apologies. Try to keep this PG, parental guidance suggested. Oh dear. Oh, okay. Again, another disadvantage of not using the gyro controls. Couldn't turn around fast enough to shoot that person. That got stuck there. Okay, this area is pretty clear. Oh, this again? Really? The nerve of some people. Jump and flip. I'm being echolocated. I'm being shot at. Okay. Tried to get up there past them, but it didn't work out. Someone said booyah when they were dead. No. I'm getting tired of this. I think this might be the first match in this particular play session where I've lost. So, I mean, decent record, I guess, but still a little disappointing. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not. We're hanging in there. Our team's hanging in there. Come on. Try and get a little bit more turf covered before this match is over. Come on. Oh no, we were about to win too. We were about to win, but they took the match over at the very last few seconds. Ah, man. That's too bad. Still got 650 points, so I still get 2 Splatfest points, which is fine. Next match. Let's get this over with. Yeah, that's another thing. So, you're probably familiar with this already, but as you grow, get more flags, like the toasty smoking so hot, you actually lose more points if you lose. So like if you're toasty, you lose a half a point if you lose a match. If you're smoking, you lose a whole point if you lose a match. If you're so hot, you lose a point and a half. So that's pretty much the same way it goes in rank battle, where it's basically less rewarding to win and more punishing to lose as you climb up in the ranks. So that's too bad. It looks like I'm not gonna be able to get up to so hot in this playthrough because I don't want to play for super long. Oh, someone's already moving. Oh, hello, it's an ambush. Oh dear, I should have expected that when I saw the ink trail end abruptly. Recurring theme with me in this game is a lot of could've, would've, should've. I mean, that's just a thing that happens, but... Oh dear, okay, I will do some recon on that. It's okay, buddy. I got this. Looks like I may... Oh! Looks like I may be having some connection issues there. That's the same person who I had that murder-suicide with. No, it's not murder. It's not suicide. No death. Sorry. My goodness. This person is just driving me nuts. I'm gonna go somewhere else. should have just decided to go somewhere else right from the start. But no, I had to go right back to where I was before. That's okay, you can keep that zone for now. Water slides are gonna get wrecked. Yeah. I am such an MLG pro at this. Everybody is just getting wrecked. Including me! I'm getting wrecked too! Get rid of that. Is it called this? Is that the sprint? Yeah, that's the sprinkler. And the thing with the, like the fold-out thing that looks like a sprinkler is actually the splash wall, I think it's called. Oh! I was about to say, it's only a matter of time before the other team realizes that that section of the stage was getting covered in greens. It's only a matter of time. So that's okay. It's okay. I'm more concerned about just getting as many points as I can now. And we have just gotten destroyed. Like you'll see this. It's rather embarrassing. I tried real hard, but didn't work out. Yeah, really embarrassing. Oh, someone's using the NZAP 89. That's cool. Alright, let's see if we can win one more. Let's see if we can win one. I've got enough time. And then back down to Toasty. Big deal. What's the big deal? What's the big deal? Anybody remember Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends when Blue dressed up as a stick of deodorant? That was hilarious. What's the big deal was his variety show, because the stick of deodorant brand was Dio. So if you like that, go find Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends on iTunes or wherever. I think it's actually on the Boomerang channel, so if your cable package, you get Boomerang. Oh, great. Four level 20s. If you get Boomerang, go watch it. Go see if you can watch that episode, because it's pretty hilarious. It's one of my favorites. Alright, let's try and win this. Hopefully we can. Although, probably not, because we've got an Aerospray MG and an Aerospray RG on the other team. So that's gonna be a bloodbath that has already. I just immediately got shot. Please? That was a waste of time, you idiot! Like, I mean, I realize I'm an idiot when I play this game, but come on. Let's see if I can take out the splatter scope. Will they take out? Take me out! Take me out, Franz Ferdinand. I say, don't you know something, something, something. Oh! Oh, really? Oh, really? We're gonna do this! Oh! Jose, you are distracting me. You are really good at this game, and I am falling for every single one of your traps, man, but boy, is it fun. Is it fun to play cat and mouse with this person? Oh, I'm coming to get you! Gotcha! Ha 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 ha! Ha ha ha! It's about freaking time! And they're probably, and probably gonna come back and just snipe the heck out of me. Oh, next, okay, okay. Too bad we can't get a hold on these people. I'll tell you, come on, come on, come on. There you go. He answered my come on. Okay, we definitely got our butts handed to us there. But I mean, I scored a decent amount of points, so I'm not sure if it goes... I'm not sure if the Splatfest battle ranking goes by the number of wins, the number of points that the teams get, so... We'll see what happens. It looks like the Splatfest is gonna end in about 6 hours as I'm recording this. It's actually... It's not that late, I mean, it's... It's later evening here over in the East Coast, so I'm going to call it a night because I have some editing to do on this so I get it uploaded really quickly. So thank you so much for watching. If you like this video and you want to see more content, leave me a like, leave me a comment, subscription, whichever you prefer. And I'm not sure I'll be doing any more playthroughs of Splatoon until another Splatfest. Maybe I might do one when the next stage comes out. So hopefully I'll do some playthroughs for that. But until then, I'll see you later. Okay, thanks everybody. Bye-bye.